It's time for your escalation, culture war escalation update for the day, week, whatever. It keeps happening. I've talked about how things will escalate and get worse. There's supposed to be some big, you know, Patriot Prayer, Proud Boy, Antifa thing happening in Portland. But we've got cultural problems that are showing the divide is getting worse, and it's getting worse faster and faster. I have two stories for you. First, a New York Times op-ed that claims it's not arguing for doxing ICE agents and then basically argues for doxing ICE agents. And another story that basically talks about how society should fracture in two and we shouldn't give any food at restaurants to certain people. Basically, someone got spat on, Eric Trump. What the story is basically saying is that you shouldn't have to serve people who spread hate or whatever. The problem with this, when society is, you know, when a culture starts to shift based on their opinions, like civil rights, for instance, it works. It's fine. You have social cohesion and all society starts to get pulled in a certain direction. People eventually decide some things are or aren't acceptable and then we change them. There are things in the past that we no longer do anymore and we all agree they're bad things. I'm not going to name any specific things, but you know what I'm talking about. However, today, the Democrats and the progressive activists online have shifted so far to the left, they've jumped off of the path of social cohesion. So the path can shift slowly, and there's fringes that get dropped off, but for the most part, most people are staying within the line. But now you have this road where most of us are, and then the left just jumped right off of it. And now they're demanding no one from this line be allowed to go to restaurants, and people who are working certain jobs in law enforcement should be doxxed. I see this as a necessary step in a full-on civil conflict. Okay, when we get to the point where you've got red and blue, you know, somebody wearing a red cap is now persona non grata, you can't even go to a restaurant, and it's happened. Eric Trump shows up, gets spat on. People have hats on, they get attacked in the street, they get yelled at, someone splashes a drink in their face. These are the things that need to happen. Businesses excluding people, that's what you need to happen for an actual conflict to occur, a true divide within culture. So imagine this. You're an individual. You want to go shopping and buy a candy bar. They say, who do you support? Who'd you vote for? You say, hey, man, I don't know anything about that. I don't want any trouble. No. You got to tell me. The divide is serious. Or worse still, imagine if you're like, hey, man, I'm proud of who I support. And they say, you can't shop here. You can't have food. You can't have milk. Then you're going to see a bar for Trump supporters only. A bar for Antifa only. You literally can't have that. But that's the divide. That's going to lead to full-on social upheaval. I don't know what'll happen. I don't. But let's check out some of these stories. Before we get started, head over to timcast.com/donate. If you want to support my work, there is a monthly donation option through PayPal, a crypto option, a physical address. But of course, just share the video if you think it's good. YouTube doesn't suggest my videos anymore. That's just how they're doing it. So I rely on you guys to suggest my videos. Feel free not to. If you don't, then I don't deserve it. This story from the New York Times, it says, everyone involved in harming migrant kids should be living in shame. Writing to representatives won't be enough. Each individual in the system, including the foot soldiers, has to feel responsible. Now, here's the thing. They bring up some interesting points. I don't completely disagree. The conditions at these detention centers are horrifying. Let's fix them. Good on the Democrats for finally stepping up and approving this package. It's a $4.6 billion package, which will go to, you know, funding beds and improving the conditions for these kids. We also have to recognize we have laws, and you can't just, like, you can't have law enforcement just not enforcing law. We have to change it. We have to figure out how to improve the situation, and it trickles down. The government says do X, like legislators will say do X, then it goes to the executive branch to do that thing. It's not like right now, The ICE agents are doing what they're legally supposed to do. Just because something's legal doesn't mean it's right. I don't think the solution is right now to have all ICE and CBP just stop working. So we need to have a process to improve the conditions. We're on track. We need to have a process to get law enforcement to, you know, be held accountable. I believe we're on track. I'm less confident in that regard. But I don't believe CBP and ICE agents are evil, nefarious actors. But we do need better circumstances. However, I will also say people should feel personally responsible. It shouldn't just be about following orders. You should accept what you're doing and you should believe you have a right to do it. And if you, at any point you think what you're doing is wrong, you should stop. Okay? But here's the thing. They take it one step too far. They go full on Antifa, basically. So first, they say, the debate over whether concentration camps is the right term for migrant detention centers on the southern border has drawn long overdue attention to the American government's dehumanizing treatment of defenseless children. Defenseless children, please. Can we talk? A pediatrician who visited in June said the centers could be compared to torture facilities. Seriously, just stop. Having studied mass atrocities for over a decade, I agree. Okay, okay. I can appreciate the New York Times criticizing the far-left Democrats, but also running this op-ed to an extent. I don't appreciate them calling for doxing. But I do like that the New York Times is at least putting some, you know, balance in what they put out. They say at least 7 migrant children have died in U.S. custody since last year. Not the fault of CBP or ICE. It's the fault of the parents who brought them on a dangerous journey without resources, and they got sick and died. They also go on to talk about children and kids who have died out in the wilderness. Again, the problem isn't CBP and ICE. It's the parents who are bringing these kids on these dangerous journeys. So I'm not going to read about their silly, you know, shock content, Sri Lanka, Congo, etc. They say what's happening at the border doesn't match the scale of these horrors. But if, as appears to be the case, these harsh conditions have been intentionally inflicted on children as part of a broader plan to deter others from migrating, then it seems the definition of mass atrocity. I really don't think that's the case. I certainly think that, you know, you're going to have politicians who recognize the bad conditions will be a deterrent. But I don't think we're at the point in this country where ICE agents as individuals are going, "Yeah, ha, ha, we're torturing children." Like, no, that's crazy. That's not what's happening. I'm sure they're like, "Oh man, we need beds. What do we do? Don't have the budget, don't have the funding." It's not like Trump is the one restricting access to funds. He just pulled emergency funds that and they tried stopping him. Okay? So can we be honest about what's going on? The Democrats have obstructed the funding for the most part. Look, there are probably some Republicans who are bad people. Like, actually, no, there are Republicans who are bad people and making this problem worse. But you got to throw some of the blame to the Democrats for obstructing funding. Let's get to the bigger point, though. I don't want to make this about the immigration stuff necessarily. It's about escalation. Here's what they say. The identities of the individual CBP agents who are physically separating children from their families and staffing the detention centers are not undiscoverable. Immigration lawyers have agent names. Journalists reporting at the border have names, photos, and even videos. These agents' actions should be publicized, particularly in their home communities. This is not an argument for doxing. Oh, it's not. It's about exposure of their participation in atrocities to audiences whose opinions they care about. You mean doxing? The knowledge, for instance, that when you go to church on Sunday, your entire congregation will have seen you on TV ripping a child out of her father's arms is a serious social cost to bear. The desire to avoid this kind of social shame may be enough to persuade some agents to quit and may hinder the recruitment of replacements. For those who won't or can't quit, it may induce them to treat the vulnerable individuals under their control more humanely. In Denmark, during World War II, for instance, strong social pressure, including from churches, contributed to the refusal of the country to comply with German orders to deport Jewish citizens. Yes. Okay. Full stop. This statement is made under the assumption that the ICE agents live in communities that aren't conservative and disagree with them. If you're an ICE agent and you live in an urban environment where they're all liberal, then sure. But if you're an ICE agent and you live in a rural conservative place, people aren't going to be like, "I hate you." They're going to be like, "You know, we got to figure this problem out, man." And also, the people in your community know you. You know, look, I've seen celebrities walking down the street. I saw Glenn Howerton. And who else did I see? I think it was Rob McElhenney. It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia and Caitlin Olsen. I think it was Glenn and Caitlin walking down the street. And I am a fan of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. And I didn't realize it was them. Okay. And they're famous celebrities. And then it wasn't until like my friend was like, "Oh, hey, it was the It's Always Sunny people." And I was like, "What do you mean? It's the people, wait, what?" And they're like, "Yeah, the people from It's Always Sunny just walked by." And I was like, no way. And I looked and I'm like, that was them. Oh my, I didn't even realize. Like, how many times has it happened to you? The reason I bring that up, imagine there's an ICE agent you saw on TV, and now there's a dude wearing, like, jeans and a t-shirt having a burger. You're not going to recognize that person. The argument is insane. I'll tell you what would really happen if you dox these people. Antifa will show up to their homes and hurt someone. Crazy people will threaten them. That is not the answer to this, okay? Making things worse, that's what you will do. I honestly don't like what's happening at these centers. I demand change. And I've said it over and over again. I'm glad. And I've said respect to Democrats for getting on board and providing the funding. Finally, they're the ones who obstructed. Look, I'm going to say this, man. The only reason the conditions are as bad as they are is because Democrats have kept obstructing. Plain and simple. Why? And they finally give in. Okay, this is what Trump was talking about. God, oh, I just can't stand it. I do not. Look, Trump's demeanor gives liberals a gross feeling. Trump, like, I get it. There are people who like Trump. I know a lot of you guys like Trump. And Trump comes off as a gross person to liberals, at least. Here's the thing. I can see past that, and I hate that they make me defend him. When Trump presents an idea, I'm willing to listen. The way Trump behaves makes me uncomfortable and angry. But I'm not a crazy person. That means if Trump says a crisis at the border, I'll say, all right, and I'll look it up. And sure enough, there is one. So the nasty man I don't like was right. Fine, I don't care. Solve the goddamn problem. Now you got me saying damn. Yeah, seriously, YouTube can restrict some ads if you say damn. I'm not even kidding. So look, I've said it a million times. I, as well as many other like moderate centrist types, get frustrated when it's like, why do you make me defend this man? His policies are akin to Obama's on immigration. I'm not opposed to some of his policies. But when Trump came out and said there was a crisis and they ignored it, here we are. Now you got me ranting on immigration again. The bigger point I want to make is you can't dox ICE agents. Look, I get it. We don't like what's happening. I certainly don't. But let's slow the roll. We don't want a total collapse. Hey, man, I like eating cheese. I don't eat cheeseburgers. I was going to say I like cheeseburgers. I mean that metaphorically. I like being able to sit down at a restaurant, enjoy a nice chicken, bacon, avocado, you know, with some sweet potato fries, because things aren't that bad. Don't make them worse. Don't incite people to run around doing crazy things. Let's stop this. Let's get the Democrats and Republicans on board right now and say, do something. And that's happening. Okay, good stuff's happening. But now they're saying they're going to refuse you service at certain businesses. Well, you know what? You have your right to do that. But I'll tell you what. When they start publishing these stories saying dox law enforcement and don't let people dine at your restaurants, we are seeing parallel societies. That's the risk. It's not here yet. But you've already got Gab and Parlay. What's going to happen when only liberals use Twitter and only conservatives are on Gab or Parlay or Minds? Minds is actually pretty spread out, so I don't want to use them as an example. But I'd feel bad if I didn't mention them because I like them better. And that's why, full disclosure, the building I'm in, it's shared with Minds. And it's partly why I'm here. I believe that they have the integrity to defend free speech. But anyway, I digress. The point is, what happens when people are actually solidified in tech bubbles they can't even break out of? Not good things. What happens when you have to look on the door to see if they're going to accept you, your service? And there's like, that business is okay and that business isn't. That's the precursor to full-on civil conflict. I'll leave it there. You got me ranting on immigration. But stick around. I got more videos coming up in a few minutes, and I will see you shortly.